So, welcome back to Rulani Insights with Rolf and...
Hello everybody, how are you all doing?
What do you have here?
I've got a disgusting bowl of poo! Well done, we can pull it out. So what we've got here is some lovely dung beetles. We can actually classify them in four groups. I'm just going to go through all my files and just try to remember. I know it's the cryptocoprids, polycoprids, exocoprids, I think, and then there's another one. But anyway, it's a coprid, okay? But anyway, what's busy happening here, as you can see, they're busy moving around and wiggling here. The ball would be... I just want to figure out which one is the girlfriend. So they're busy pushing it around, so... Yeah, it's a difficult story. You'll find them that they come around and then you get the hijackers. Alright, he'll fly over and he'll see that there's a nice lovely ball. And that's probably what happened here. So there is a lady. The lady is busy holding on here at the moment. It's this one. So the lady will hold on and then the males will roll the ball around. Now he's gonna go and find himself a nice and lovely soft area where you can actually borrow the ball. You'll actually dig a nice hole.
But before you continue, somebody told me once we always have two of them, right?
Okay.
And now there's a third one.
Yes, he's the hijacker.
So why do we have the hijacker?
The hijacker, the polycoprids, yes.
Oh, that's now
so
I
So the cleptocoprids. Okay, there's the four. It's okay. Yeah, they enforce groups. But the hijacker will fly over. He'll see, oh, okay, there's already a girl there. And there's a ball, so let's go and fight for it. So that's probably what's busy happening here, is the lady is busy holding on, she's here, and the boys will fight in between each other to see who's going to get the lady.
That's an interesting one.
Very, very interesting. So,
can I touch one?
Yeah, go for it.
Oh, yeah. Now I was scared, sorry. No, silent.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Nothing happens.
No, nothing happens.
But they could fly away, right?
Yes, they can. They can definitely fly away. Where I wanted to get at is you might find that these balls get rolled around by one. So then there's one busy going around. That is a feeding ball. Mm-hmm. All right? When there's a lady holding on, then it becomes a breeding ball. Alright, you see. Okay. But what I want to show you, which is very, very interesting.
Do you have that close to the camera?
I might be able to show you, yeah. So you're going to have to come and look underneath in the sun. If you look underneath the mandibles there, there's actually little parasites. You see those little white things there? Those are parasites. So these little parasites, they stay on the mandibles. And these parasites...
It's sharp here, huh? When you press a bit.
Oh.
Like
so,
this.
Okay. Yeah. These little parasites actually feed off of the fly's eggs. So this is why South Africa doesn't have a big fly problem. They actually... Yeah, the parasites look after it. I know that Australia, they came to fetch these little insects, but they sprayed them because they saw the parasites.
Right.
Now they've got a dung beetle problem and a fly problem in Australia.
Super!
But yeah, very, very interesting.
Thank you!
Something cool I can go along and talk a lot about.
They are very, very
interesting.
Super! Thanks,
sorry,
Rolf!
Sorry, Rolf!
For that, the first block, you even have now dirty hands.
It's alright.
Super nice.
I wonder
story.
Which one is the female. Because she's holding on here.
Okay.
Yeah. But anyway, yeah.
That was Rulani Insights. Thank you
very much. Have a nice one. Thank you.